Continuing from last week, where we trapped a knight on an infinite chessboard, this week we'll come back to a regular chessboard and we'll see how we can solve the eight queens puzzle problem. I think we are on, gentlemen. Welcome, Divakar. Yeah, this I think would be your first time on our podcast. I know you. So Divakar is a regular subscriber to our channel, and this week we've invited him to join us in this coding session. So welcome, Divakar.
Nice.
So Ravi, once again.
Once again, back to my chessboard.
Back to your chessboard.
Right.
So we'll solve the eight queens puzzle.
The famous puzzle.
Yeah. Have you actually solved it?
I would have solved it just by trying random things.
Random things.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. So.
And getting frustrated after six.
Okay.
Six is easy. Seven and eight becomes very tricky.
Becomes very tricky.
Yeah.
So that's where computers come in, right?
Right.
Yeah. We'll just have the computer solve. Solve the puzzle by itself, because you have so much computing power.
Exactly,
the computer can just basically place the
try so many
so
things.
Many different.
But there is some logic to it, right? It's not
logic.
Random.
Yeah, I mean it's not random.
Correct.
Yeah, so it's called as the backtracking algorithm. So we just look at a very simple case scenario. Where we look at the backtracking algorithm. All right. So let's say you have a chessboard. Now there is a reason I have chosen the 4x4 chessboard. And this backtracking algorithm essentially places n number of keys, n number of chessboards on an n-sized, n number of queens on an n-sized chessboard.
Right.
So if this chessboard was 4x4, it should be able to place
four
queens. All right. Now there is a reason why I have chosen four queens. The size is four, because on a 2x2 chessboard, 3x3 chessboard, it's not possible. But on, let's say, a 5x5 or a 6x6 would be too big for
cumbersome.
Me to explain.
Yeah.
Right? Would be too cumbersome for me to explain. So 4x4 is like an appropriate size.
Mm.
All right. So let's start logically placing these queens on this chessboard.
Mm.
Okay. So where would you place the next one?
Mm.
I think everybody's favorite logic is just do horse moves until you run out of space. Right.
Mm.
So let's place the next horse move, which is here, or it can be here. Let's place it here. Where would the next one be? It would obviously not be here. Right? Where would it be? Would it be here?
Yeah.
Yes, that's where it would be. So there you go. So you already run out of space to do it.
Yeah.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
This is how humans generally tend to solve it.
Mm.
But if we allow computers to solve it, we can use a different, we'll use a different logic. We'll use the backtracking algorithm. Now, how it works is you start by placing the first queen on the first column. So the column that you're trying over here is column one. All right. Start placing it on, let's say, the next column. Can you place a queen over here? No. So you cannot place it over here. So that's out of the question. Can you? So what happens is, for every column, it tries all of the rows that are possible. So the next column, it's not possible. Over here, not possible, because the queen places a threat. So let's say I place over here. This is possible. All right. So now, because this is possible, this is allowed. So it moves on to the next recursion. All right. Now, what do I mean by recursion? Which means, after placing this one, it basically calls on itself to call to place the next queen, next piece. So what happens? Can you place the chess move here? Because that's the column, right? So this is the column. Can you place it here? No. Can you place it here? No. What about here? No. So because this is not possible, it backtracks and removes the entire chess piece and moves on to the next possible location. Now remember, we started from here, column one. The recursion takes it to the next one. To the next one, we already tried this and we placed it here, right? And then it moves on to the next one. So is it possible to do it here? Yes. It is possible. Then it moves on to the next one. Is it possible to place here? No. So you can see that almost all of the places are run out, and the columns have also run out. So it, now we have seen that it is not at all possible to place the chess piece anywhere. right? So it backtracks and removes the entire thing.
Mm.
And then it moves on to the next location, which is over here.
Mm.
All right. It keeps on backtracking until it finds an appropriate solution.
Mm.
So let's, once again, let's try to solve it. So over here, so it starts from here, not possible, not possible. So yeah, it moves here, not possible, but it moves here, that's possible. And once again, it needs to backtrack and then remove the entire solution. All right.
Mm.
Now, if you let this run for enough number of times, or how many other moves are available, you'll see that it will place all of the chess pieces, in their appropriate boxes.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So that's how it essentially works.
Mm.
Now let's look at the pseudo code.
So for that 4x4, we can start by.
Where was that? Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
So the 4x4, the solution would be queen here, right? On H1.
On H1 here?
H1, right? On H1.
Above that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So if you start from there.
If you start from there,
then
where would the next one be?
Mm.
Would it be here?
No, J.
You can keep it.
Remember the recursion ties the next one. It's not possible.
Yeah.
So the row, not possible.
Not
possible.
It is possible.
It is
possible.
Here. So it places it here.
Right.
Where is the next one?
So the next one is not possible here.
And
not possible.
Already you have run out of you have run out of rows. Out of columns.
Right. So it removes this particular option.
It removes this.
And then goes to the next column.
Yes, it goes to the next one. So
right.
It's possible over here.
No, over here.
Oh yeah. I mean it does start from top. It does start
right.
from here.
Yeah.
So it does this. That works. And then in the next one, once again, it's not.
It'll come to this particular.
So
at some time it'll wrap around, right? It'll place it here.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, so that's like, so that's not the algorithm. I mean, that's not what we'll do in our algorithm.
Okay.
We'll just let it evaluate every location on the.
Okay.
And a very simple recursion algorithm actually does.
Right. This solution here and.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
So it starts from here. It could start from here. All right. I'm going to remove everything. Then it goes to the next one over here. It's possible, so yes, it would place it. Then once again, over here, it's not. I mean, there are no solutions over here, right? Oh, yeah, there is a solution here.
Mm.
So it would place one here, and then I think this one over here. So
exactly.
Yes.
So this is the four by four.
Yes. So it would have generally solved it. Now let's look at what it looks like in the pseudocode. This is actually far more simpler than. What you would expect out of such a complex behavior from a computer. Right? So let's say I have a function called placeQueens and it takes two parameters, a chessboard, which is a double dimensional array containing all zeros. Zeros is empty, and if there is a one, it means there is a queen in that location.
Mm.
And then a column number. A column number usually starts from zero. All right? Now, if the column is greater than n, where n is the number of, or is the size of the board, then it means it returns true, which means it's done.
You're
placing,
done with that.
I'm done placing all of the, not done placing all of them.
Mm.
It means I have run out of the columns.
Whether
I have placed.
Which is what you said,
number,
it won't wrap around.
It won't wrap around. Whether I have placed it or not, it doesn't
got
matter.
Got it.
If it is done, means I have only managed to place three or four on the board or something
got it.
Like that.
Mm.
Now for for an index from 0 to n, this is for the rows. So you have the columns, I represent the rows. It will check if it can place that place a queen on that chess piece.
Right.
If it can, then it will mark it as 1, which means the queen is placed over there.
Right.
And this is where the recursion happens.
Mm.
Now if the recursion, now the recursion basically just calls it, but says column plus 1.
Mm.
So it moves on to the next
right.
column and starts once again placing from 0 to n. That's what it does. And then it returns true if it is able to place it. So remember, this method needs to either return a true or a false.
Right.
It will only return a false if it was unsuccessful in placing it anywhere. Basically,
in
it
this
went
column,
through
if
this
it
entire
could...
loop through all
Very
the
nice.
Rows and nothing it was able to place.
Nice.
Right. Now, this is where... if it was successful in placing the next piece, it immediately returns a true so that the recursion algorithm
can
go on to the next row.
Right.
If it was not, it would place over here, and this is where the magic of backtracking happens. Which means it says chessboard of I of which means just play, remove the queen from there.
Right.
If it ever reaches this place, it means remove the queen from there.
Mm.
That's what this means.
Mm. Got it.
Simple as that.
Right.
And then that's all it is. I mean, it's just a few lines of code that manages to place all of the queens on a given chessboard.
Very nice. I think what it uses is that in a solution, every column must have a queen.
Every column must have a queen.
That's what it's using.
Yes, that's
right?
what it uses. Yes.
Very nice. Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So let's look at what it looks
What about
like.
The can place function? We have
to
code that.
Can place function. Yeah. I mean, we have to code it. But let's basically look at a chessboard.
Mm.
And let's say the queen is over here.
Mm.
Can I place a chess piece here?
Mm.
I mean, there is a logic involved in it, right?
Mm.
Why? Because the diagonals are, the diagonals are occupied, these diagonals are occupied, this is occupied, and this is also occupied.
Mm.
So basically the only places that will remain are, you know, a few horse moves and all of those things.
Mm.
So those are the only places where it can basically place.
Mm.
So that's what the can place does, right? I mean, it just looks at all of the rows, all of the columns, the diagonals on the top left, bottom, top right, wherever, right?
Mm.
So this and this, it checks all of these and says, if it is possible to place it, then place it. That's what the can place function does.
Mm.
I think as we code it, it will become very clear.
Mm.
All right. So let's just go to the coding part of it.
Mm.
I'm going to keep this open because I might use the, so what I have is, so because we are essentially just carrying over from last week, I already have some of the code ready for this. I'm going to have the console open also.
Alright.
So I already have some of the code ready. What does the code do? It essentially it draws the checkerboard. And then I've just placed a queen over here. Alright. So let's just look at the code and see what we are using from last week. Once again, the index.html has a canvas and everything. And then the JavaScript file. It has... So one thing to note over here is that is the queen character. Now I'm using the Unicode queen character, which I have taken from this Wikipedia page. I'll link it in the description and everything.
So for example, I didn't know that Unicode has all these.
Very cool. So so you can use this U+265B, and how you put it in JavaScript is you just declare the character
/U 265B
without the plus. Don't put a plus over there because then it's an error. It's no longer an escape a Unicode character. Anyways, so once you have that, you can place the queen character wherever you want. What are the methods we have? We have a method called getPosition that we used last week, and what does it do? It just given so what is this? So let's just look
check
at what this board is. So this board is 800x800 pixels, and I am putting 8x8 chessboard on it. So therefore, each cell of this board is 100x100 pixels. All right. So so if I give a position on this checkerboard array, all right, then where is the location? I need that position function. I also have a function called put text at index. I mean, I think we have seen it last week, where if I give an array location, it will place
the text
the text on this one. I have the draw checkerboard method, which just uses a loop to essentially fill in a checkerboard, and then I have the init function. The init function essentially initializes the canvas. It also determines the square size. The square size is nothing but the checkerboard's size, or the checker size or whatever. All right. And said, take a note that I'm setting this font to 120 pixels, in size, so that I can draw the checkerboard, big and thick. And then I have to draw checkerboard, and then I have to put text at index, and then I put the
you're
queen
starting
character.
Off with that.
So that's what essentially renders it. Right. So if I was to change this to 1,1, you'd see that it moves to the next one. Alright, so that's what we are. So that's what we are doing. So let me comment this out, and let's start placing the algorithm. What do we need? So we can just essentially, what I'm going to do is just start typing this out. Can I just take this and then,
maybe we can just start replacing.
Yeah, we can just start with this. So I'm going to create this function called.
Place queens.
I mean, this algorithmic thing or the pseudocode thing, and I'm going to start converting this into a JavaScript function. So I have a function called place queens, which takes a chessboard as an array, I'm going to change this variable name to a board, call it, and then a call to column. So I can say if call is greater than n, n which is already declared over here as 8. All right. So yeah, so if it is greater than 8, then just return true. Now this
shall we make the array the a?
Oh yeah, the checkerboard array. Right. Yeah, we'll make it in time. Meanwhile, I just wanted to get the code in place where I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. So I do this. Remember, I don't have this function called can place. All right. If you can place for the board, take the I, take the what's the column, place the queens. Yeah. So it'll just be a board of I comma call is equal to 1, which means basically there is a queen over here, and then it's just calling itself with a board and then just the column plus 1. Right, I mean, if it was successful in placing it, it just returns a true, or else it doesn't return, or else it just basically backtracks it. So a board of I comma column is equal to 0. That's it.
Call there also line 72.
So column plus 1. So yeah, so that's all I have. Yes, and like you said, let's just initialize our board. So what, so I'll just have an array and I'll call this I'll call this the queens array or the chess array or the board array. I'm going to call this the board array. All right, which is this one, and then I'm going to init this over here. How am I going to init this? I'll say for where I is equal to 0. We're going to see a lot of these loops today. I less than n, right? I mean, because we're going to render this, you know, do something with it. So I plus 1, board array dot push. Push what? Push an array for variable j is equal to 0, j less than n, j plus plus. Right, board array of I dot push 0. So I'm pushing the number 0 on that board array, and just so that I can see, you know what? Thanks to the magic of JavaScript, I don't even have to do that. So, anyways, I have this, so it's declared the array, but take a look at this wonderful thing. On the on the console itself, you can say console.table of whatever array you have, it'll like beautifully
prints it
place
out
this
nicely.
Here. So now you can see that it's a proper double dimensional array. All right, and I know this is when you start bragging about how much more simpler it is in
Python,
Python and everything. All right,
okay.
So now we have the array defined. All right, what's next? The next thing we would need is definitely the can place function. All right, so I'm going to start defining this can place function. What does the can place function require? It requires a board, it requires a row, and it requires a column. So I'll declare. A row and a column. All right. This will either return a true or a false. If you can place something on the chessboard, then you can of course do it. So now how do we do this? All right. So the first thing you will do is determine all of the items on the rows, all of the cells on the rows.
Right.
So I can just do that by saying check the row. I say for where I is equal to 0. I less than n, I plus plus, and I'll say if a board of I comma call is equal to 1, return false. All right. Is that correct? Yeah, that's the row comma. So so that's the row comma column. I can do the same thing. I can just basically use the same loop but I can just transpose this and I can say, oh yeah, so this would be rho comma I. That's it, right? So now I have taken care of the row of the same row and the thing on the same
column,
on the same columns.
Mm.
This is the easy part.
Mm.
The difficult part are the diagonals.
Mm.
All right. So let's say, okay, so what cell is this on? This is on, okay, so this is the top left is 0, 0, and the top
bottom right,
and the bottom right is the 7, 7. So what would this be? This would be 3, 3. So if this is 3, 3, what would this be? This
2, 2.
Let me just increase the font size. All right, so this would be 2, 2. This would be 1, 1, and so on and so forth. And this would be 4, 4, and 5, 5. So that's easy to figure out. But what about this? If this is 3, 3, this would be 2, 4. Correct? And then this would be 1, 5. And this would be, what would this be? This
4, 2. 4, 2.
4, 2, and this would be
5, 1.
5, 1. Is that
yeah,
right?
That's correct.
Yeah,
and 0, 6 and 6, 0 also.
Oh, okay.
For this.
Yeah. Anyways.
Yeah.
So you can see the pattern of this increment and
yeah,
whatever.
Mm.
All right. So let's try to figure this out, right? Like, so what would your loop look like? So we will have to basically have, well, to check the diagonals, what I'm thinking is that we'll just have four different loops, right? Which checks this diagonal, this diagonal, this diagonal, and then this diagonal.
Oh, okay.
We can handle rows and columns quite easily.
Right.
Diagonals are a little bit
tricky.
So we can start with this, essentially. All right, so we can start with the top left diagonal.
Right.
Okay. The top left diagonal. All right, so I can say where I is equal to 0, I know your I can say where I equal to 0, I mean I have two variables, I and j, where they are equal to 0 or they start with 0, and then I'll have to say while I is where I is greater than the row and j is greater than the column. Right, so basically I'm
greater
saying, oh no, do I have to start reducing them? I mean, do I have to take this one and then start reducing them? Yes. So I'll say where I is equal to row, j is also equal to column. So j is equal to column. All right, so let's say I take this one. I'm saying go on the top left. Right, so I'll keep reducing.
Correct.
Until one of them reaches a zero.
Yes.
Right. So, so what I'm going to do inside the loop is say I minus minus j minus minus. So I'm basically reducing them.
Correct.
But how much I will reduce them by? I'll say do it until I
either I or j
greater than or equal to zero, and j is greater than or equal to zero.
Correct.
Right.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Do that.
This makes sense.
That's it. And then we just have to check this very condition over here. If I or j is equal to 1, then return false.
Correct.
Okay. This is the top left. All right. This is top left. The same goes for the bottom bottom right. Okay. What do? I once again, I start with the row. Hold on, man. I should actually start with row minus one. Yeah, when I start with the top left, I should start. I shouldn't be counting this. I should be starting from here. So it should be row minus one.
It's okay. I mean, just one extra call. It's okay.
And when I'm starting at the bottom diagonal, I should start plus one.
Okay.
Plus one.
Mm.
All right. And I should do it until it reaches row minus one and j less than or equal to call minus one. Yeah. Right? Oh, sorry. Less than call minus one.
What? Till n, na?
Yeah, till
n. N.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. You're right.
Less,
you're right.
And if you're using less than, only purely n.
Minus one.
No.
N.
n,
n minus 1. N is 8, right?
Yeah, but you're doing strictly less than, no? You're not doing less than equal to.
You're right.
Correct. And yeah, I plus
and plus.
Plus
n, yeah.
Very nice. Mm.
All right.
Mm.
Now let's say we now we have to take care of
those two.
Okay. So this is the top right.
Mm.
So this is the top right. Now the beauty about this is that we can we can let everything else remain the same and change only this. So what would this be?
Mm.
So this would be row minus one,
column plus
minus,
one.
Yeah.
Column plus one.
Yeah. Minus one.
Mm.
Column plus one.
Correct.
Row is greater than or equal to zero, right?
Yeah.
Right, because that's what we did here.
Right.
Greater than or equal to zero. I
yeah.
and J and I
minus minus.
Minus minus.
Perfect.
And the same thing happens to the. So it would be the exact opposite case where, yeah, I'm so glad it worked out. So worked out well. So I is less than or equal, oh no, less than N and J is greater than or equal to zero.
Yeah.
Right?
And yeah, flip
and
these
then,
two.
Yeah, flip these two as well. Okay.
Nice, looks okay.
Okay.
Mm.
And we can like easily test this.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, of course
okay.
we can. Yeah.
Okay.
So basically what we can do is we can place the queen on the chessboard somewhere.
Mm.
So we have this, right?
Mm.
So let's place the queen.
Mm.
So if I say I and J, oh sorry, not I and J, I'm sorry, 0, 0. So I'm basically placing a queen, and let me also just put it so that I can, for now I can just represent it so that visually we know it's there, is equal to 1. So I'm just placing it over here.
Correct.
All right. So I have it here and I can say,
can place, no?
Can place at, let's say, 1, 1. Cannot read property undefined of undefined. Oh, that's good.
No, we didn't call the
62
init.
It says.
Okay. I called. Why? Did you call the init that you did, no?
Yeah.
You made the array and you passed.
Yeah, because if I say
okay.
console.table of.
No, you're not passing a board to can place here.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. So can place board array 1, 1.
Yeah,
if I do this, there you go.
Perfect.
Because I cannot
yes.
place it over.
And
here.
Then and some other.
All right. What about a horse move? So
yeah.
that would be
1, 2.
1,
that should
2.
Be true.
It's undefined because at the very end you're not returning anything because if all
you're not
works,
returning
I should say return true.
Perfect.
So there you go. So that should work. So if I can say once again can place port array 1, 1 should return a false. Can place there you go. So that returns a true. That indeed does return.
Perfect. Nice.
All right? So now we have the can place method in function. I mean in place. Then you have this. Then you have the place queens, which basically places it. And what are we done? Oh, hold on. Let's just also render the board. All right. So right now we're just doing this. So let's just render the board. I'm going to call a function, or I'm going to create a function called render board or something or something to that effect. Okay. Okay. And this will just basically go for I equal to. Just going to copy this. And I'll say if board array of I of J is equal to 1, then put text at index I comma J put the character.
Right.
That's it. Right.
Yeah.
So I have the render board, which I'll call from, so I don't even have to do this. I'll just say render board. Let's see if this works first. All right, so yes, of course it works because it did manage to render it. But can I just call the algorithm right now?
Yeah,
it looks
queens.
Like it should. I should be able to do it. So I'm going to comment whatever it was. I'm going to comment it. Given our reputation, what do you think are the chances that it will work? So I'll say place
first time
means
is, it's okay not to.
On this one, column start from 0. All right?
Okay.
I'll say.
Whoa, so fast. Wow.
Actually, yeah, let's just verify first of all.
Yeah, it
one,
looks
two,
correct.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah. Yeah, that was fast. That's it.
That's it.
And for a change, because of Divakar being here, we worked first time.
Yeah.
Presence does matter.
Yeah, presence does matter.
So yeah, so that did work actually.
Yeah, yeah, that
now,
was very good.
Mm. Yeah. Mm. This seems like it is the only solution, but remember that we are starting from column 1.
Mm-hmm.
Now the thing is, you cannot start from column, I mean your from column 2, for instance over here, because it will only manage to place 7 queens. Because it started from the second column.
Right.
Yeah, it only managed. Yeah, so over here.
There's no backtrack happening here.
So we only go. So the column wise, we are only going in one direction.
Right.
It is possible to modify this base algorithm so that it can go around.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So that it can check if it has gone around n number of times.
Yeah, right.
Wrap around
n number of times. But in this case, I think we are.
Yeah, we'll stop and then
we can have that as a challenge.
Yeah.
All right. But here's the thing, right? I mean, I was actually working on this one yesterday, and I did manage to complete some and put this on my site. The code for which also I'll put it on the description of this one. So I'm going to my site, but I have this working, and it works out all of the different solutions for the same problem. So it also does this animation. The animation part is actually quite simple.
Yes.
But don't let that intimidate you, because I'm just basically evaluating and then just placing them one after the other.
Yeah.
The code should be self-explanatory.
Right.
So there you go. These are the other solutions for this. But this just cycles through all of the different rows.
Right.
There are, I think, 92 different solutions.
Oh, is it?
I think
I didn't know this. Okay.
Maybe you should Google that.
Okay.
You
wow.
Yeah. So I have this
eight queens puzzle.
Yeah. Number of how many solutions does it have? Wow. I don't know why it should be 92. That'll be interesting to know. Why is it? Why is it 92? I know you understand there are 64. Very interesting.
Has 92 distinct solutions. The solutions that differ only by symmetry operations of rotations and reflections. Then the puzzle has only 12 solutions. I mean, it has 92. You can take a solution and then mirror it, and that also is a solution. So that in this thing that I have done, right, I'm also placing dots. Basically represent places where you cannot place a queen.
Correct.
All right. So on top of this, I also have a board at the bottom where you can actually play around with this one. So you can.
That's nice. Yeah,
See how much you are able to come up with.
Six is the natural when you try it on your own. Six is the very
so
cool.
I want to make a statement here.
Sure.
Okay. See this backtrack. Backtrack is like if you're getting lost into a forest.
Right.
It's like it's better you come back to the starting point and then re-enter the forest again, rather than having to figure out the way from where you got lost.
No, you're saying re-enter the forest again from the beginning. That's easy for us to say.
Correct.
It's easier for the computer
because
to do.
It has resources.
Yeah, because it has resources.
Yeah, infinite.
Quite a lot of resources. That's correct.
Like I remember once I was in Gir Forest.
Yeah.
So we were on our own. The authorities told us to have a guide, but we said, no, we'll figure it out.
Okay.
But we got lost. Everywhere it looked same. And then we had to retrace the path and then start from... it was not easy.
Okay.
So backtrack was a very interesting work.
Yeah. So you had to come... How deep did you go?
Yeah, a few kilometers.
Oh, okay.
Not very
deep. Still.
But once you are away from the bearings, the sun is up.
Yeah.
You have no idea which is east, west, north, south.
Right. Right.
And everything will look similar.
Yeah.
Very easily you'll get lost.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, so that was the eight queens puzzle.
Yep.
I think today's episode was short and sweet.
Yes.
I liked it.
Very nice.
Working on this one. So that's about it for this week. Please do like, share, and subscribe. Tell your friends about this channel. If you want us to keep making more content like this, leave a like and a comment.
Awesome, special new topics to touch upon.
Yeah, awesome new topics to touch upon. You know, and if you want us to code something, let us know.
Thank you. Yep.
Good.
Yeah. Thank you very much.